2000, Broads wakes up, and still more ridiculous Bryce Harper news. I told myself, stop! Stop! Just stop! And here I am. Here I am, after more reports. Now, take this report for what it is, because it seems fishy to me. But there is still some legitimacy maybe behind it at the same time. Because you take a look at who's reporting it. He's been around the league. There's some ties with McPhail. He's been involved in the MLB. He has some sort of sources. But I understand that it seems odd. And I'll tell you why. So on MLB Network, and on Twitter, actually, two different sources talking about the Phillies' offer just isn't where Bryce Harper and Scott Boras, where they want to be. It's not close to where the market is for Bryce Harper. And we hear the number 270 to 300. Now, this is why it doesn't make sense. If you're the Phillies organization and you see that Bryce Harper declined a 10-year, $300 million deal, why would they ever throw something less than 300? Why? That's what makes me feel like it's hard to believe this. But at the same time, why hasn't the deal gotten done? There is a reason why. Because the money's not there! So if the Phillies organization really botched this, well, let's be real, they already botched it. No doubt they already botched it. Even if we land him, this thing was screwed up, this whole entire process. But, oh my god, if they really did not offer him anywhere from 330 to 375, they're dumb! Dumb! Let's take a look here at... Well, we'll take a listen. I have the audio of Jim Duquette talking about the offer from the Phils.
I'm hearing that the Phillies have made their offer and it hasn't moved. And now they have a feeling that they're not as likely to get him, at least right now. Now, again, is it not the biggest offer? It's not the biggest offer from what I can tell.
It's not the biggest offer.
No.
You think that what, San Francisco has more guaranteed money on the table?
We don't know yet exactly where the Giants number. That's the problem with it. Like, you don't know for sure. But what I'm hearing is the Phillies have been around anywhere between 270 and 300. They haven't moved. And that's not going to get it done. And that's not where Harper's going to sign. So your rankings are correct, I believe. I believe you'd like to go Dodgers first, Giants second, Phillies third. But I don't think the Dodgers are gonna end up in that dollar range.
All right, that's not all. Andy Martino's been tweeting about the Phillies' money and how much they offered, and says Philly's still engaged on Bryce Harper, but as of late last night, sides are still significantly apart on the dollars. Harper would like to beat Stanton's deal. Okay, so come on! And then he replied to himself and said, it's never been merely the players' question about the Phillies. The team has so far held firm on money too. The issues on both sides. And that's what I've been saying all along. People say, he doesn't want to be in Philly. He wants to be here. He doesn't want to play in Philly. Philly sucks. It's about the money. It's about the money. Clearly, we're nowhere near where we need to be. And that's really frustrating. It blows my mind. Blows my mind that we sit here and we know that Bryce Harper declined a $300 million deal with the Nats, the team that he's comfortable with. We know he declined that. And we're going to offer 270 to 300? That's so ridiculous. It's a shame. It's a shame because, you know, all these moves the Phillies made and the team that's playing right now out in Clearwater getting ready for the season, it's all going to be killed. It's all going to be really, really died down because of the stupid management up top if they don't land this guy. So take it for what it is, because I see it as how. Just... How? How do we not offer him more than $300 million? It doesn't sound right. I saw reports earlier in the week that said we were at the 10-year, 330 mark. That seems more realistic. It just, you look at it as a use your logic situation. You can't imagine that John Middleton and Klentak sat together and said, let's offer him less than what he declined, right? I mean, that's impossible. That you would have to think that is literally impossible. But then you think to yourself, why hasn't it gotten done? This is Philadelphia sports in a nutshell, and this is what happens. This is what happens. Your upper management blows an opportunity. Blows an opportunity. And you hear the Giants are in the mix now with the 10 years. They're going to piss this thing away. They are literally going to just throw this in the trash, and it's really upsetting. See, you take a look at how much we signed Andrew McCutchen for. Everyone's all upset because, oh, did we overpay for Andrew McCutchen? He's getting paid a pretty decent amount of change a year, but we're not going to pay Bryce Harper a decent amount of change a year? I am so pissed if this is true. So pissed. I literally told myself, Broats, you know, this is like day 3,000 for you of waking up screaming to YouTube about Bryce Harper. Do not do it today. So I had a Sixers video ready to go. I said, all right, here, this is what I'm going to write. This is what I'm going to talk about. I wrote down my notes. And then this thing just starts blowing up on Twitter. Jim Duquette on MLB. And there has to be some truth to it. I'm sorry, but there has to be. And it's pretty much because the deal has not been done yet. There is a reason why. It is not because he hates Philadelphia. He doesn't want to play in Philly. That's not what it is. It's money. It's always about money. That's what it's about. And the Phillies organization is butchering this thing. Butchering this thing. If these reports are true. And it's making the fan base sick. And it's ruining another season if we end up not landing him. And I even mentioned this last time. Even if we do land him, doesn't it still have a sour taste in your mouth at this point? And it's not Bryce Harper's fault. It's not Scott Boras's fault. This is the Phillies' fault. This is the organization's fault. That's whose problem this is. They are handling this situation worse than you ever could imagine. Ever. We're going to be hitting March. I made the jokes consistently mid-March. I was somewhat joking. And we're really going to get to that point. We actually are. We might even not even see this damn dude till April. And he might not even be wearing the Phillies pinstripes. At this point, I just don't even know. But oh my goodness. If this report is true on how much money we're offering. Are you delusional? Are you delusional if you're going to sit there and think that that's going to land Bryce Harper? Oh my God. This can't be true. This can't be true. Use your logic. How could this be true? How can you sit there and not offer him more than $300 million? Right? Right? I need to know what you think down below. I need to hear your thoughts on this because it's driving me crazy. And I'm going to tell you, I plan on taking it calmer with this situation. And with that being said, there's a chance I have another video up later on it. There's a chance I have another video up tomorrow on it. There's a chance I have a video up on Saturday about it. There's a probability I have a chance that there's a chance I have a video Sunday about it. It's sickening. Right now, I feel sick to my stomach if these reports are true. Hard to believe they are, but at the same time, no, it's not, because there is a reason why this deal has not been done. And that reason might come down to we're being soft. We're being stingy. We're not using the stupid money to go out and get a star. He only hit 279, bro. He stinks. 249, whatever. Whatever the hell he hit. What was it? Why does 279 stick out to me? But I feel like it was 249. Yeah, 249. He hit 279 for his career. Okay. Yeah, but how about his OPS? 889. How about his 100 RBIs? How about his 34 home runs? People don't value the 100 RBIs for a team. Okay, think about what that would do to our squad. Let me know what you think. I'll see you next time.